All right, here we are. We're gonna do another What's in the Collection video. And this one here is pretty popular. Everybody wants to see the Charvel guitar. So I have all the Charvel guitars out over here. Let's start with some of the earlier stuff. So if I come over here, this here is actually a Model 1A, okay? This came out in about 86, 87, okay? It's Japanese made. In fact, if you look at the back of the headstock, it says Fort Worth, Texas, even though this was not made in Fort Worth, Texas. This is a Japanese made Charvel Model 1A. It's a little modified. It did not come stock with DiMarzio pickups, and this pickguard was changed also because it was volume tone or something like that. This is just a volume tone with some DiMarzios. Love this guitar. It actually reminds me of an old Kirk Hammett 80s Fernandez style when he played the black guitar with the white pickguard. Okay, so again, you know, you're looking at a guitar that's many years old. And truthfully, as much as I love the stuff they make in Charvel today, nothing quite feels like this era of Charvel, okay? So Model 1A. I also have, let me put that down, a Model 1C from the same era. This is the Jack Butler style, right? Candy apple red. This actually was covered at one point, but the cover is taken off. This guitar also has some upgrades like the graphite saddles. But again, for the most part, it's, you know, it's an old guitar, but it looks good. It plays great. Also, that Fort Worth, Texas, although it's not made in Fort Worth, Texas, it's a Japanese-made Charvel guitar. Again, this one here is the Model 1C, okay? Same era Charvel, we have a Model 5, okay? This here is the Model 5. That's when we get into the active electronics with the mid-boost circuit. This has a Jackson-branded, licensed Floyd Rose tremolo, okay? This is basically a Jackson soloist, an imported Jackson soloist, neck through. This has the candy apple, excuse me, the, what color do you call this? Like metallic purple, midnight purple, something like that. I don't remember the exact color, but love this guitar. This is the Model 5, and I also happen to have, now remember, this is the Floyd Rose Trem, Jackson branded, Model 5 with the dot inlays. Also have the Model 6, which is right here, and the Model 6, this is the first year of production. It has the Kaler flyer, made in USA. You see that right there, made in USA, okay? These are also USA pickups, the Jackson pickups, okay? One has the JC80, the other one has the JC50 between the Model 5 and the Model 6. These are the BC Rich ST3 style on-off toggles, which you really don't see too much of anymore. Bound neck, shark fin inlays, same color, interestingly enough, but bound all the way to the top. And same thing, made in Japan, okay. The serial number starts with C, which somebody, that should indicate something. Maybe the Cort factory? I don't know. If you know, let me know. Okay, so that's that. So those are my old Charvels, okay? So I have four of them. Then we get into some of the newer stuff. If we take a look over here, here are two guitars, which are basically pretty darn close. Let me put one on each shoe so I don't have to hold them. This one here is a SoCal, right here, made in Mexico. This one here is a SoCal, made in Japan. And if we get a nice close-up, let's look at the necks. You could see a huge difference of the neck, how pale this one is, and how nicely finished the Japanese one is. Can you get a nice close-up of the actual neck? Okay. So I'm gonna put one down. We'll go through one at a time. Let's start with the Japanese one. Okay, let me put this down. So this one actually I bought off Robert Baker, a good friend of mine. You probably all know who he is. So this was the first year the SoCal came out. made in Japan, came stock with DiMarzios, and a, let me just see something, yeah, a top mount Floyd, okay? And you could see that the Floyd is resting on the top, okay? The, I don't know if you could get the grain in the neck. You see all that pixelation in the neck? You see it? Kind of, sort of? Let's see. So, and this one here, it's funny because this says P.O. Box 245 San Dimas, California, but it's made in Japan, okay? And it's just a great guitar. Grover Tuners, really just, it's a wonderful playing guitar, okay? In fact, let me have that camera real quick. I want to show everybody just the detail on the neck over here. You could see how nicely finished all those fret ends are on this one here. Okay, so this is the made in Japan SoCal. Now, if we take a look at the made in Mexico SoCal, it's a little different. The neck is more of that natural neck, okay? You still recording? Natural neck. Duncan's and a non-surface mounted Floyd Rose, okay? Recessed Floyd Rose. And outside of that, you know, basically the same guitar. And again, you can see over here, this one here is made in Mexico, okay? But both of these guitars are real nice guitars. Love that style. And I have to be honest with you, both of these guitars are pretty heavy. I don't know the exact weight, but they're not light. Okay, let me put these down. So then I get into something pretty similar, which is really light and just is a tremendous instrument. This one here is the Jakey Lee Signature Series Charvel, the first year Charvel Signature Series. The pearlescent paint, Duncan DiMarzio stop tail, okay, no trem. One volume, five-way, and just a gorgeous guitar, okay? And this one here is made in the USA. Goto tuning pegs, okay? And I love this guitar. I should play it more than I do. It's a little out of tune, but that's this one right over here. And then, while we're on the topic of Signature Series guitars, of course, have the Warren D. Martini USA-made snakeskin. They also make an imported copy of this, and it's not exactly the same. Love this guitar. I think this was maybe a Mike Learn paint job. I'm not sure. Surface-mounted Floyd, Duncan, another Duncan quarter pounder, the 24th fret area. Matching headstock, same type of natural neck. Love that Japanese neck, that like tinted neck. And even the these covers are actually like machined aluminum. I don't know if the camera could pick that up, but you know, just a custom guitar. We have Warren D. Martini's signature right up at the top over here. Of course, it's not his real signature. It's like a decal. And then the tuners on here are Schallers, made in Germany, Schaller tuners. So, again, two Signature Series Charvels guitars, and I love them both. Last but not least in the collection, I have a Star guitar, which, to be honest with you, was an impulse buy. I was in one of the big box music stores one day and saw this on the shelf for like $300. It's got an EMG 81, an EMG 85. It's got a real Floyd Rose, a neck through, three-piece neck. I was like, how could I say no, given the price? With that said, it's made in China, okay? And it says right over here, crafted in China, a genuine Charvel product designed in the USA. And the reason why it was probably so low, this was probably a $700 or an $800 guitar, but this style guitar is very niche just because of the shape. Pointy guitars aren't for everyone. So I probably got this at a dealer cost or below cost type of thing. So certainly a cool guitar that's ready to rock with great trim, great pickups. And it's a great looking guitar too. It's just a tremendous price. So there it is. There is my Charvel guitar collection. Let me put that one down. I hope you enjoyed this video and subscribe if you want to see more like it. I have lots of guitars in my collection. So some upcoming stuff you'll see in my BC Rich collection and a whole bunch of other stuff. So little at a time, stay tuned. And until next time, I'll see you later.